agenda. Their agenda is to basically keep everyone fractured from information and from any kind of harmony within our lives and our social aspect of our lives. That agenda translates into other issues, including greed, opportunity, aggressive actions that keep, well, shall we say, that keep people from coming together on issues. In the past, long ago, we would socialize around the church. We would come together in groups and do our praying and our socialization with two different aspects. One for the ability to deal with spirituality within our own religions, and then the other one was basically to come together as community members to support the community effort. Well, I personally believe that a lot of that has been lost. The ability to come together and help and harmonize within each other. But there's one other aspect, and I'd just like to touch upon it, is I think the day has come where more people realize the truth in regard to that we've been visited and we are being visited than those who don't believe it. I think more people are aware, but there still is a fear factor. Anytime you don't have information, anytime you don't have, you're kept away from those who can give you a better education on things, the result is fear, the absence of information. And we still are living within those boundaries in some regard, some respect, because the amount of people who have actually listened to those of us who have had contact is a fairly small percentage of the overall populace of the whole earth. And I believe that it's spreading. This information is spreading quickly. People are coming together, talking more and more about the true aspect of our lives and our lives intermingling with extraterrestrial life. I think we are beginning to assimilate those ideas into our culture, which makes us stronger as a whole, as a species. But there's a lot more information that people don't know, and we need to educate them. We need to find ways to bring people out of the fear, out of the darkness, and to let them know it's okay to not know something, at the same time to give them the tools to learn for themselves.
We had our first documentary shot in May, May 9th to be exact. After we shot that documentary, some things happened. Can we go into that? What transpired after our first meeting?
Well, it's something that I've been reluctant to talk about, but I will talk about it. At least get it on the record for this time. Over the years, I've been pursued by some pretty bad people who seriously have tried every way possible to silence me and this information from coming out. They've done everything except kill me. After we did the interview together and a few days went by, I traveled to Europe to talk to some people in regard to a conference that I was hoping to attend in Switzerland. And basically what transpired is they set out to kill me. They set out to assassinate me in a fire in a hotel. I was locked in a room within the hotel. The hotel was set on fire. And I barely escaped alive. Now, I won't physically give you the details of how I got out, but I will tell you that for four months, it was very difficult. I had a lot of medical problems. I was burned inside of my lungs, were burned. I've had lung clots because of it. I've suffered some minor heart attacks because of this. Your pulmonary system, your breathing system, basically affects your entire body. So when my lungs were damaged, it basically damaged my entire circulation and breathing and immune system. So for the last, from the time this happened, until about 4 months after, I was literally in and out of the hospital weekly, and sometimes for months at a time. I believe that this was intentionally done. We have located the people who planned and perpetrated this, and those people have basically been taken care of. Authorities were contacted in some respects. They helped to handle this circumstance and to legally take care of some of the aspects of this. But what we found out after this had happened was the lines drawn back to the original planners, that they were involved with several sub-governments, some agencies that many times people say are involved in black ops or dark operations or illegal operations. And it's what most of us have always known, that there is an apparatus set up to basically squash any information and its validity, to basically target those people who are willing to come forward and talk about what they know. Now, this has happened for years and years during all the time that I have been talking with people, but never this severe to me personally. But there came a time where I think the information that I was talking about and revealing publicly around the world was noticed to be damaging and basically outing some of these people that have been giving and perpetrating the disinformation. I think it got too close to home. So they just decided they had an opportunity to take me out, and that's exactly what they set out to do. And they almost were successful. My feelings about it is anger, of course, frustration for, you know, having been laid up for 4 months, basically 4 months of my life being gone. It's been very difficult on my friends and my team to be able to deal with this situation, when for approximately 2 months they didn't know if I was going to survive it. We put a lot of things on hold because of necessity. The public who writes letters to us and to me didn't get their email answered for a few months because we were in the process of trying to understand where this attack came from, who initiated it, and who was to blame. So for that, I apologize to people who were asking questions and wanted to know why I wasn't answering, but I wasn't able to. I was either in a coma half the time